Hey everyone, I've tried many different ways to change the Mark IV nozzle, but this is my favorite method and I think it is the quickest and easiest way to safely change the nozzle. So it requires using a couple of these tools and I will talk about them in the next few steps. So first of all, you want to make sure that your filament is unloaded, which I assume most of you know how to do through the menu right here under filament and unload filament. You also want to make sure your nozzle is cooled down before you do any changes, and also make sure to adjust the extruder position to kind of like the middle right here. So I would do that right now. Now we turn off the printer. Make sure to protect your heat bed with some cloth. And now you can open the door up. Before you do anything with the knobs and loosen it, you can see that I have a sock here. There's actually two of these tools that I've printed. One is the one with a sock and one is the one without a sock. Now I've tried both of them and I find that the one without the sock, you can tighten up the nozzle at the end more easily. So actually I would recommend printing this one. The link will be down in the description below. And I would recommend just taking off the sock in order to use this tool. So what you'll do is pretty easy. You can see that this one is the smaller one without the sock. So it actually just snaps right in. So you can see it's pretty secure. Now what this does is that when you loosen the nozzle, this clip, orange clip here that I've printed, will actually hold this block, the heat block. So you will not, it will not drop down and it will be much easier to change the nozzle. Okay, so now that we've installed the heater clamp block, you can now loosen these two screws. And we will use the second tool here, which is basically a wrench. And it has this hexagon right here, which matches the nozzle. And what we'll basically do is we'll just unscrew it. It'll just come out. See this? This whole thing will come out and you will not need to remove any cables. Now to install the nozzle, again, very easy. So take your new one, just push it back in. Now you can use, I find it easier to use your hand at the beginning. And then once you get to almost there, use the wrench tool again. Get it tight. And you can't, please don't over tighten it. You can feel a little bit of resistance here. And there we go. The nozzle is now attached to the heat block. Now before you tighten these screws, make sure to push this up as much as possible. And then just tighten these screws. And make sure when you tighten these screws, don't clamp on any cables. Now the maker of this clamp tool does recommend printing this in a bright color so you remember to remove it. For me, I use the silicone sock, which I highly recommend. Link in the description below. Now that the sock is installed, all you have to do is close the door and that is it. So the other thing to remember to do is to change your nozzle diameter on the Mark IV. So you have to go to settings and then hardware, nozzle diameter. Make sure to tune it to the new nozzle diameter that you changed to. So I just changed from 0.6 to 0.4, click 0.4, and that's it. Hope you found this video helpful. These two tools that I've printed, the links to these printables are in the description below. Please give a like and subscribe if this was helpful, and happy printing!